I'm depressed. What is the point of life? What is the meaning of all this? Is it all just some sick joke that we're all telling each other each and every day? The anime community has really gone downhill. But I guess I should start my intro. I guess I haven't really made up one. This is Mr. Hull Awesome. And, is Deku six quirks? Is his six quirks all awesome? Of course not. Let's get into this shit. So, Season 4 of My Arcania just ended. Pretty good season. It had its ups and downs, but good season all along. Spoilers! Shit. Forgot to say spoilers. Last episode, at the end, Deku has a dream where all the previous users of One for All are there and All for One is there, yada yada yada. Some weird shit. And I was like, this is the thing, isn't it? This is the thing. You see, the manga is way past the anime. And I had heard this rumor that Deku had more than one quirk. And I was like, but that doesn't make any sense. He already has a quirk, you know, at the moment. Why would he need any others? I mean, his quirk is already badass as is. But let's just get into this. First off, we need to talk about how One for All doesn't really make a lot of sense, really. So, correct me if I'm wrong, they said that All for One had a brother, right? And then, like, his brother, like, he made it to where everyone thought that he didn't have a quirk. And then, like, All for One gave his brother the stockpiling quirk. But his brother already had a quirk, which was to give other people quirks. I mean, to give other people, you know, quirks. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, please correct me if I'm wrong. I think that his brother's real quirk was to give other people quirks. And, you know, All for One just gave him the stockpiling quirk. Or was the other way around. Just whatever. The point is that he could give other people's quirks. And with that being said, everyone else, I thought that they all had super strength since I was an idiot and didn't know anything about All for One. I mean, One for All. I thought that everyone else just had super strength, but it turns out that they all had different and unique powers, which is cool. But, so, what you have to realize is that it's not like he could give them the quirk to warp reality. One for All is made to only become stronger than All for One. So they're not going to become as strong as Superman. They're not going to become as strong as Goku. They are only meant to become stronger than All for One. That is the point of One for All. And that was good enough for me. I mean, All for One himself is already strong. And, you know, I'd like to see all their unique abilities. I actually would. So, you know, whatever. It's cool. It's totally cool. So that was pretty much out the way. You could pretty much just assume stuff about One for All. But then, so I looked it up, right? I was like, so All Might can, like, transform. Well, like, I thought that whenever I first saw, you know, anything, I thought that his powers were, like, he could transform into this guy, into his muscle form. And that, you know, he has super speed, super strength, and he can send out... He has super speed, super strength, and then he can send out shockwaves, you know, with a mere wave of his fist. But after looking it up, it says that he has, like, kinetic energy that he pumps throughout his body or some shit. Look it up, it's some weird shit. But what they don't state is, like, like, All Might and Deku, sometimes he'll just be punching someone, and then out of nowhere, their freaking arms will explode. And then, their arms will just heal and be able to punch them again. It's this weird thing that happens a lot. It would have been cool if they said if you got One for All, you would get, like, this healing quirk. You won't be able to defeat death. Like, if you're killed instantly, then, yeah, you're dead. But it would be cool to say, like, if you have One for All, you have the quirk of healing. You know, that would be cool. Because, like I said, like, look at this moment right here. Like, his arm exploded. And then somehow, it just became muscly. Like, what if it, like, better if, like, muscly, but, like, still purple, like, blood gushing out? Because, like, you can't just make it to where your arm is all muscly, and, you know, it's magically just healed. You can't just do that. But it's just... Now that I've explained why One for All is just a little bit wacky, but not too stupid. Like, it's easy to understand, it's easy to assume things. It's time to get into the point of this video, the title of this video. It's time to get into Deku's motherfucking lack whip. Allow me to explain. This shit is completely bullshit. You cannot deny it. Like, I can't wait to see all of your guys' fucking comments saying, oh my god, it's because of Destiny and shit. I mean, like, hell, what I love is, like, most of the time people are in the comments on YouTube, they're like, oh my god, it's like Aang from The Last Airbender. And, like, I laugh at that, because I love The Last Airbender, but the point is that My Hero Academia is supposed to, is meant to be in a more grounded, you know, place of reality. I mean, most comic books are like that. Yeah, you gotta have all these guys with these warping reality shit, but who cares? It's all a part of the rules of superpowers, you know. And you can't have it to where somehow magically Deku can get it. I mean, have any of you asked yourselves why All Might didn't have 6 quirks? Or I bet you're just gonna be like, oh my god, All Might can't get the quirks because his hair is yellow. Like, seriously, what the fuck? Whatever explanation that you're gonna try to give me is gonna be retarded. You're gonna be like, oh my god, he was destined to do it. Since he's a kind-hearted little kid, he can have all the quirks that he wants. Me. Now, you know what? To be honest, there are two types of My Hero Academia fans. The first type is the type that I can agree with on some point. The first type of fans of My Hero Academia are the spectacle fans. They really want spectacle. You see this awesome scene right here? It's so good. These fans aren't actually bad. There are other fans like this, like, Dragon Ball Super fans. The two arcs are pretty bad in the animation, but once it actually got good, people were like, holy shit, these fights are so cool, man! But the story and everything else is complete garbage. So, what I love is whenever some of the fans of Dragon Ball Super, they're like, I know that the story and everything else is complete garbage, but I like fight scenes. And I totally understand that it's garbage, though. And I'm like, thank you for your brutal honesty. I'm an action junkie myself, but I'd rather like more plot and better shit that makes sense. And I mean, I'm glad that you're a Dragon Ball fan, because a true Dragon Ball fan would know that this shit is complete garbage. Thank you. The point is, Vegito, after he did his final Kamehameha, Zamasu should have died right there. Should have been erased from existence. But that didn't happen. The Trunks thing happened, and it was just a bunch of shit. Now let's get back to My Hero Academia. As I had just explicitly said, I actually don't think that these fans are that bad. These are in most animes, you know. It's just, like, even if you're just reading the manga, you'll see how awesome it looks. And you're just like, oh man, it's so cool, and you don't really, like, see what's wrong with it. Because you're just blinded by the awesomeness. You're blinded by the spectacle of how it looks. Now, how about you? Turn off that side of your brain. You need to turn off that side of your brain and think a little more critically. You think that we like doing this? We like shitting on shit? Shit. You like doing this? I want to watch good stuff, and whenever something is bad, I'm gonna gripe about it. It's not because I'm a whiny, petulant fucking asshole. It's because us humans are prone to making up entertainment. We are made to tell stories, and whenever that story is so subpar and bad and complete shit because the person who was telling the story didn't even give a shit, then I have the right to say that it's complete garbage. I need you to turn off that side of your brain that likes My Hero Academia just because of the spectacle and realize that some of the stuff is just bad. Just sit down, hear me out, just hear me out, just let's have a conversation, please. The other My Hero Academia fans are the idiots who think that there's nothing wrong with their fucking anime. Everything is so perfect. They're so toxic. Not everyone is, obviously, not everyone is toxic, but most of them are, and it's just stupid. No anime is perfect. Perfect. Everything has a problem. And My Hero Academia, I might review it one of these days, but it definitely has some problems. I just don't get it. Like, people are really toxic. God. One of my favorite YouTubers, Nunchaku. Taku? Shit, I'm sorry that I probably said it wrong. One is, he made up a video on fucking Deku. How, you know, Deku sucks as a character. Please go and watch his video, you know. I am not doing him justice. Like, his video is hilarious, but he's totally right. And, obviously, he knew there were gonna be some toxic people in the comments. I mean, most of the people agreed with him, duh. But, you know, if you look in the comments, you're gonna find that one guy who's just like, oh my god, I hate you, Nox, I'm gonna fucking find your house and fucking kill you. Like, these people, they get so overprotective over this shit. Like, Jesus Christ. The point is that Deku doesn't need this quirk. He doesn't need Black Whip. He doesn't need to float. Don't you see that a character must progress? If a character doesn't have any stupid ideals or any stupid character flaws or whatever, then he must go through a character change physically instead of mentally. And he doesn't do that. I already reviewed Deku Full Cal 100, and it's completely retarded. A little girl that he is meant to save saves him. Saves him! He couldn't save her. He couldn't fucking save her. He couldn't. And I bet you're gonna be like, and that's why he needs Black Whip and shit. No, he doesn't!
You idiot!
Are you stupid? Are you fucking stupid? The thing that I loved about All Might and Deku is that their powers were so simple. They didn't need no reality warping. They didn't need to fly or shoot lasers. All they needed was strength, speed, and power. That's all that they needed. He can use his powers in so many ways. He can jump super high and just, you know, flick his fucking, you know, fingers and then be able to fly around. I mean, and with his speed, he can just go zoom, 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 just defeat any villain. I mean, like, it's stupid how you all are trying to say that, oh my god, Black Lab is so good, blah, 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 blah. The point is, Deku was constantly this is nothing but hand-holding. Him having these other quirks is hand-holding. And like I said, like, I hated that. I love Aerie, and, like, it's not fair. He is supposed to be saving Aerie, not her saving him. Did any of you all even think about that whenever he was doing it, you idiots? You fucking idiots. I hate you. I hate you, like, literally. Like, I don't even get it. Like this is anime. Think for a second, you dumbasses. Think. You know what? I can't. Like, I can't with these people. I like, legit can't. I'm so done. I'm done. Like, I'm serious. Like, I'm done. Like, they're not even gonna watch this video. They're not even gonna take the time. And I can't wait for their comments to try to explain this shit, because it's not going to make any sense. I don't care. I don't care if fucking Nanashimura was like, okay, so we're gonna give the seventh user of One For all of our powers, okay? Okay? I don't care if one of their quirks is to go back in time and give other people powers. I don't care. Your explanations are gonna be trash. You guys are idiots. You know how I said that Dragon Ball Super's retarded? Well, I'm actually redrawing it. I'm writing an entirely different story in my own headcanon. You see, if you're a true Dragon Ball fan, you wouldn't take Dragon Ball Super as canon. You would switch up everything and make it to where it was perfect, and that's what you do. So with My Hero Academia, there's a couple of things that I'd switch up with Deku. First of all, I'd make it to where he would stand up for himself most of the time. I made it to where Bakugo wasn't such an asshole. Like, once Deku gets his powers, Bakugo's like, hey, Deku finally got a quirk. And then they both become rivals. I was gonna change up a lot of stuff, but I can't wait, because either I'm gonna read the manga or I'm gonna wait for the anime. And I'm gonna watch it. Whenever he uses Black Whip, I'm gonna be like, oh, why didn't he just jump to the left, jump to the right, and just lift up that, and just blah, blah, blah. I could literally make it to where his quirk is so versatile. He does not need Black Whip or Float. Anyway, I'm done with this shit. It is a fact that this is wrong. This ain't some dumbass's opinion. This is a fact that he does not need Black Whip, and it doesn't make any fucking sense. It doesn't. So this has been Mr. All Awesome. Please like and subscribe. Also, like and subscribe to Nuxtaku. I don't know if I'm saying it right, but he is hilarious. And he is really good at analyzing anime. And, yeah. Black Whip and all that shit fucking sucks. I hope that most people are out there. Changing stories. Like, whenever I watch something that's bad, I usually just think about something that could make it better. And I'm totally in denial about it. And I don't even think about it. I just feel like, that didn't happen. That never happened. This is the end of the video. Stay all awesome, and I'll see ya.